bus start.
Look, I was giving that Kevin one down the bank. He's going to help Sinbad get off. You're just going to make things worse.
I'm not going to give him down the banks.
Oh, what are you going to do then? Ask him politely if he's involved in all this?
He is, it's obvious.
Look, what good's it going to do you going down there? He'll call the busies and it won't be Kevin that gets done.
He won't call the busies, not if he's guilty. He never last time, did he?
It doesn't mean he won't this time.
I'm telling you, he won't, not if he's guilty.
Yeah, if. Look, Tim, you were lucky that you didn't go down for that computer stuff. The last thing you need is getting caught down there. You won't think that Kevin's up to anything, but they'll definitely think that you are.
Well, you're certainly not going to win Employee of the Month having a ding-dong on my doorstep, are you? Come on, Tim, big day today.
I'm there now.
Please, Tim, what about all that stuff that you said to me about going to prison and that?
That was different.
No, it wasn't. You stopped me from getting in any deeper. I listened to you. Now you've got to listen to me.
Emily, you just don't get it, do you? Now get out.
I do get it. Look, I know how much this Sinbad stuff is doing your head in. Honest. But is it really worth you going down for it?
Right.
All right. She's seizing up on me. Just can't seem to get her going.
Your car?
Of course, my car, yeah. You working?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look, I wanted to say about the other day. I pushed things too far, didn't I?
It's not your fault. Well, not really, it's me. The Jason thing.
Oh, I should have been more... Well, I shouldn't have been so... Oh, you must hate me, I do.
Don't be soft, I don't hate you. I threw the lips on you, remember?
Yeah.
Nobody pushed me into that, did they?
Did you get a dinner break?
I'm the boss.
Come over. I mean, if you fancy, I'll make you dinner. I mean, you don't have to if you...
I'd love to.
Sound.
See you later.
See ya.
Can I have another one of those, please, boss?
Another one? God, you're like a whirling dervish, you corkill.
Hey. Arlianne, Employee of the Month.
Oh, right, nice one. When did she tell you, kid?
She didn't ignore him.
Yeah, right.
It's no contest, sis. You run this place virtually single-handed. Oh, I'm so excited. I love competitions.
Well, the most deserving don't always win out, do they? And I'm not known for me luck, Lance. Who ended up in prison, me or that scheming Jackie Dixon?
No, no, no. Because this is like Eurovision 98 and you're Darna International. Now, whatever the tabloids dragged up about her past, her talent wiped the floor with a lot of them.
So give it to one of the lads you watch. It'll be Tim or Mike Dixon.
What about Mike Dixon?
Oh, I was just wondering if he's coming in for the announcement in case he gets it.
Well, I'm announcing it on this shift because all the contenders are on this shift. Now, feast your eyes on the prize. There you go, Jimmy.
Oh, so. Hey, that's a bit dusty, isn't it? Look at that. She won't want dust on it.
Or he. Where's Tim?
Oh, he's still doing the windows. I think he's using a cotton bud or something.
I haven't back selling. Wants a clear out.
I'll give it a going over, Bev.
Oh, I need you up here cleaning.
Oh, me and Lance will do it.
Yeah.
Oh, you know me, Bev. I'm never afraid to get my hands dirty.
You covering for Sinbad there?
Don't. Feel a right beaut doing this job here. But he wouldn't do it, not after he got barred. I like the way people are treating him. I'd walk, but I need the cash.
Nah, someone want you to walk. It'd be gutted if you knew you messed your life up over him.
Anyway, tell us more about your Cheryl.
She's not my Cheryl. And I don't know anymore. I wish I did.
Why didn't you get the lowdown of Steve Murray?
Nah, I feel alright if he's just strolling over there with no excuse.
Well, I saw him this morning messing with a lump of scrap in his driveway. He was saying that lads are dropping out of footy training like flies. And he asked me whether I knew anyone that might have been interested.
Oh, yeah.
What about Manchester Shell? I saw the gay scene there on this telly programme. It looked dead glam. And if you worried that someone might see us, no one knows us over there.
Did I say I'd be worried someone will see us? Why are you so obsessed with getting out on the scene? I had all this with Paula. Only no one could accuse her of being a tourist.
You are?
Oh, nothing.
Well, come on. What do you mean?
Do you know why I don't go out with straight women? Because I get sick to death of every conversation I have being about sexuality. Mine, theirs, everyone they went to school with.
We weren't talking about...
Or the gay scene. I've never been into the scene. It's not a prerequisite for being gay, you know. God, at least when you go out with a gay woman, you can talk about your day, or the telly, or the price of flaming fish.
We don't just talk about sexuality.
Linz, we damn well nearly do. I'm a designer. I'm quite interested in photography. I'm a flipping Gemini, but all anyone ever seems to notice is that I'm a lesbian. I only want us to go out somewhere. What have I done wrong here? All day, you've been going on that you want to try harder. Be more involved. You want me to show you the sights. It's just novelty, isn't it? And as soon as that wears off, you'll be back to the easier option.
I won't.
You just wait till there's a bit of pressure on, Linz, and you've got some bloke sniffing around you. There's always one handy. Look at Bev with that loser Dave. You'd be glad you didn't go shouting up from the rooftops about us.
Oh, yeah? Well, I think you're ashamed of me.
Is that right?
You may think you're so cool about it all. Why else would you not want me to tell everybody? People I know, my own family, people I trust.
You don't know you can trust them.
I know them a lot better than you.
It's all just part of the fun for you, isn't it? Not only do you get a guided tour of the gay scene, you get to shock the family as well. What a bonus.
Not what this is about.
Huh? You tell them this early on, Lindsay, and I'll know you have no interest in protecting us.
Is that right?
Yes.
I expected to find you slaving over the stove.
I was. Have been. It's in the oven. Yeah, come in.
What's that noise?
Oh, no, the smoke alarm.
Oh, this game's a wine. Where do you think you're going?
Me break.
Oh, I can see someone's not bothered about winning a magnum of champagne.
Well spotted.
Leanne!
Oh, honest to God, Leanne, they were that big. If they were rat droppings, I do not want to see the owners.
Oh, Tor for doing that for me.
I never mind, Tor. I expect champagne cocktails.
Well, that's another reason why I should win. You and me drinking champagne cocktails in front of that bunch of no marks at the squat.
Of course you're going to win. Who else is there on this shift? I'm too new. That team's scoring nilpoint all over the shop. If you don't win, I'll eat me clothes.
You could make things worse, a lot worse. If you kick off and that Kevin phones the busies.
I'm not gonna kick off. I'm gonna talk to him. I want him to know that we're onto him, and he's not gonna get away with it.
And that's what we're gonna tell him.
We?
Oh, come on, Tim. Two lads on your own. You in this state. You'll just wind each other up. That's why if I'm there, I can talk to him. I'll finish work early and meet you after your shift.
RM.
I don't know what I've done to it.
You don't think hitting the broom handle had anything to do with it?
Your dad'll go weep. Gets all caretakery over stuff like this.
What was it anyway?
You mean before I cremated it? What was that for?
Trying.
Do you want me to go out for takeout?
No.
I can make you a butty.
I don't think so.
Suppose ice cream's out of the question.
She's coming. Look at that envelope, Leanne.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be honest with you. Before I took on this place, I did not know the difference between a keg and a... what's it?
Pump.
Pump. But I did not take this on for the business side of things. Oh, no. I took it on because I wanted to bring people together. I wanted to put a bit of life, a bit of colour, a bit of style into people's lives. But I could not have done that on my own. Oh, no. I needed a team of loyal and support workers, eh? And without loyalty and support, where would any of us be?
Bad.
So I've decided to award an employee of the month. Now, this person, like me, has been through some very tough times. It takes a lot of cogs to make a place like this run like clockwork, but unfortunately, there can only be one winner. And this month's cog is... Jimmy Corkill!
What?
What? You what?
Oh, if you don't get it, I'll eat me cloth. Bon appetito!
Oh, no. Oh, she didn't mean it. She's usually a dead good loser.
No. Oh, no, her. It's one of the women Jimmy Corkill used to teach with.
He was a teacher. Our little Jimmy Mop.
Come on up, Jim.
Employee of the month, me.
Jimmy.
Jimmy?
Carol?
Blood, sweat and beers, eh, Jim? There's nothing you haven't mopped up from this floor. Come on, come and get your certificate. You deserve this award.
What's all the excitement?
Okay. You sure? You would tell me.
I'm sure.
Oh, God, who's that?
You better go and answer it.
They'll go away.
I have to get back anyway. Oh. Nicky be climbing the walls. All right, Leo.
I interrupted, so.
No, it's a good time, and I'm just getting off anyway. See yous.
Dead right, you'll make up for it tomorrow. Hey, and you can forget this skiving off if you want to go a next month's award.
It's the only time they can fit me in. And anyway, this two's been giving me jib all day.
First, David.
Don't worry, Leanne. Maybe she'll have a sour gob of the month award later on. You win it hands down.
Oh, did something speak?
Have you finished with that?
Thanks. Congratulations, Jimmy. Your award.
Thanks.
You're obviously appreciated.
You don't usually eat here?
Yeah, bit of a do. Jimmy, it's good to see you working. Jimmy?
What?
Could I have another cappuccino?
You'll have to ask the bar staff. I'm just clear.
Did she make a go for you? Cheryl, why? Eats lads for breakfast. The younger the better, or at least inexperienced, you know. Likes to pop the cherry.
No, not me.
No?
Joking, aren't you?
Just as well. Our old fella must be due back soon.
Does he come back a lot off the rigs?
Rig? Is that what she told you?
Why?
He's doing A for GBH. Or was it ABH? I think it was GBH first and then ABH once he was already in prison. And just as well she never made a play for you, mate. He's well jealous.
Yeah, lucky escape, eh?
You must be the first lad she's kept her hands off.
Is she really that bad?
Oh, Ray, don't be like that. It's best you know, eh? So, you did then?
So if no one gets away, how about you? And how come you know all this? You too, eh?
Oh, come on, you're only happy because Emma didn't get it. Oh, no, listen, thanks for all your support. I wish my dad could see me now, promoted. You know, he is a great believer that if you wanted anything badly enough, you could achieve it. And he was a great believer in education as well. That's being one of the few jobs that really makes a difference in people's lives. Not sure that'll be true about managing you lot, Matt.
A class of 30 rowdy kids would probably be easier.
Deputy head.
Don't be like that, Leanne. She'll give it to you next time. This one's probably a warm-up.
I told you, I'm not bothered.
Cliff Richard lost twice. Martial, Anne-Marie David.
Oh.
Exactly.
I really don't care. I only wanted to see the gobs on our squat mates when we swanned in there with champagne cocktails.
It will have been a sympathy thing. Did you know Jimmy used to be a teacher? Then what?
Oh, how absolutely, totally, rivetingly interesting. Not.
I just think he's taking it really well.
so if you hadn't come round, Leo, do you still think you'd have got off?
Yeah, I think I probably would.
I feel like we're back where we started this morning.
I need time, that's all. Every time I get too comfortable, I get this wave of guilt about Jason. It feels like if I move on, then he's forgotten. Like I'll kill him all over again. He only exists now in my memory, and if I let that go...
I do understand, you know. I know it's not the same, but I remember when I was a kid and our auntie first started calling Diane Mum. Well, I wanted to as well, but I felt like I was betraying my real mum, Jen. It was as if we were replacing her.
That must have been hard.
Well, she caused all kinds of trouble, Jen did. You really love Jason.
I'll understand if you want to leave her. Go and find someone with less baggage.
You're joking, aren't you? You're the first girl I've ever really wanted to go out with.
Honest?
Ever?
I've never met a lad like you before. Most of them want to get off with the first nympho that'll have them. Look at that Leo with that Cheryl one. They're all completely different.
Yeah.
So, I guess that'll be your first time.
Yeah.
Really helps with all this Jason stuff knowing that. It'll be okay, you know. I've got to be patient. That's all.
Oh, first time I had champagne. It was on my wedding day. I'd had fizzy white wine, but the posh proper stuff, I remember thinking, is this what them knobs make all that fuss about? I'd rather have a pint, me.
I love champagne.
Who's been buying you flowers?
Me. For Shelley, actually.
Oh, you made Shelley. Is it a birthday?
No.
What special occasion is it?
No, we've been staying at Shelley's mum's, me and Kylie, so it's just a little thank you.
Only I thought if it's a special occasion, she could have this.
No, it's yours, save it.
What for?
Celebration.
Celebrate what?
Well, you said yourself you're on the up. You're bound to want to celebrate something and you'd be glad of it then. See ya.
Proud of yourself?
Sure, it'll have its downsides.
Here. Enjoy your celebration.
I can't take this.
Take it.
But you won it.
What's winning? Something for nothing, isn't it? It's like a handout or, I don't know, an inheritance. Or creaming off a bonus from the people who do the real graft. They make the real difference. You take it, Callum. You're the one who's earned it.
But, Jimmy, it's yours.
Take no notice of him. He feels guilty because he won that over some stuff who work harder than him, that's all.
I really can't take it.
Do you want me to get it back to him for you?
I don't want to offend him.
I'll be dead, Sol. Come here. Champagne cocktails it is, then.
You having a kickabout?
What do you want?
A kickabout. And a word.
We keep having tiffs like that, we'll be able to open a flower shop.
I don't know why you're apologising. It's me that keeps getting it wrong here.
No, I shouldn't let things get to me like that. I'm just being a moody cow, that's all.
I'm not a tourist. It was as big a shock to me as anyone when I started falling for you. You spend your life thinking you're one thing and everything's straightforward, then suddenly everything's turned upside down. That's why I want to be out more, or out there more, you know, just help me make sense of it all.
I know. And I should be more supportive of that.
So, am I forgiven?
If I am.
Come here. And I'm not ashamed of you, Linz.
I'm proud of us. And you're right. Maybe it's time we let our hair down and went out as a couple.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'll introduce you to the seedy underbelly of Liverpool's gay scene. If you think you're ready for it.
Where are we gonna go?
I've no idea. I told you I don't go out on the scene. But we'll just get a brochure and be tourists together.
Don't care, he deserves it. Deserves it? You little meth. What are you doing? You can't touch me. I'll phone the police, yeah? The busy's on to you. They're wondering how come you're chasing after Sinbad instead of going to them first, eh?
No, they're not. I can go where I want.
Well, if you've done nothing wrong, you've got nothing to hide, have you, eh?
You're lying. Because your stupid, dirty little mate's going down. You can do nothing about it.
Yeah, get off. Come on. Call the busy's. Do them a favour. Save them from calling you, eh?
Come here.
You forgot your ball. Come on, pick it up. Pick it up.
What's going on? Just leave him alone, will you? You're that mate of Sinbad's, aren't you? What do you think you're doing coming round here, eh?
Talking.
Oh, yeah. What about? Kevin?
Footy.
Football?
Yeah. We're a man short. Ask Steve Murray. So I thought I'd come round to Kev, ask if he wanted to train. Only he started winding me up, didn't you?
Is that true, Kevin? You don't have to cover up for him, you know. One word and I'll call the police. Has he threatened you?
No.
So it was about football?
Yeah.
Well, I don't want him playing football with the likes of you. It's a dangerous enough game as it is. And if I find you anywhere near here again, I'll call the police straight away, whatever the lad says. Do you hear? Like you inside.
You better start telling the truth before I make you.
Barbara,
I want a word with you.
Lesbian or more, when did you two become an item?
The case, it's a private club. We can't just let anyone in, can I? I just know who your friends are.
You're not a teacher anymore. In fact, you never were in the first place. You were a fraud.
Where you just got?
Oh, to the gay club.
You know.
And that's on Friday at 8 o'clock. Well, next on 4, a new series follows the wannabe actors who are hungry for fame. Nothing gets in the way when you're starstruck.
We'll be right back.
to wear.
That looks nice. What do people usually wear? Gay people. Oh, leather for the men, and all the hairy armpitted lesbians wear men's suits and jet boots. Joke. We wear exactly the same clothes as a non-corrupted.
Shout! You're decent.
Got you a coffee.
Bev, how many times? Most people do wait for a come-in.
Well, you're not up to anything, are you?
Does it look as if we were?
Where yous going?
Oh, just a gay club.
You're not.
Why? What's the big deal?
Well, all kinds of thing goes on in those places.
What, like orgies, you mean?
I don't know.
Oh, for God's sake, Bev, it's a club like any other club.
I know, but...
Oh, I'm going to go for a bath. Give me a shout when you come down off Planet Stereotype, will you?
So, what are you wearing then? Dungarees, no pair of boots?
I don't believe you went down there. You told me you weren't gonna go!
Well, I changed my mind.
You had every intention of going down there, didn't you? You had it all planned.
No, I just wanted to scare him.
Oh, were you sick or what?
He's the only way we could get Sinbad off.
Oh, yeah? And get yourself sent to prison as well at the same time?
I don't care. Sinbad was right. He is behind all this.
How do you know?
Look, he must be. He lied to Barbara. He said they went round there due to footy. Why would he say that unless he had a guilty conscience, eh?
Look, this is Sinbad's problem, not yours. Why do you always have to gag
it? Because it is Sinbad. You don't get it, do you? I am not going to let Sinbad go down for something he hasn't done.
You're just being stupid. We've already got that tape hanging over our heads. You're just going to make things 10 times worse.
How many times do I have to tell you? The tape's well gone. It must have got lashed after the party or something.
I hope you're right, Tim.
Look, if someone had it, we would have well aired by now, wouldn't we?
I hope so. Or we've had it.
What time's Gemma arriving?
Well, 10:30.
In the morning?
Well, the city council.
Yeah.
Oh, it'd be nice for you having her around again.
Yeah, no, I can't wait. We'll get over 2 hours later and get a room ready. Yes.
Hello.
Is Sinbad there?
Hang on. Sin!
Yeah?
Barbara?
I want a word with you.
What about?
You've got one nerve. When are you going to give it up, eh? Sending bits of kids round to tell your lies.
What?
I'm sick of it. I've had enough.
Who's been round?
Oh, don't give me that.
But I haven't got a clue what you're on about.
We've had a visit from Tim, the last lad you took under your wing.
Tim?
She means the little fella, you know, lives over the road.
Yes, Jimmy, I know what she means.
Who's it going to be next day? Him? Or your mate Mick?
Hey, don't ask me to go.
Look, I didn't send him, I swear. He must have gone round off his own bat.
And what do you think you're doing?
Carry on camping. We never got round to watching it, did we?
Oh, Mick.
Look, this is one of my all-time faves, second only to Carry On Screaming.
I thought you wanted to get Gemma's room ready.
Yeah, I will after this.
I think not. Now, come on. Shift yourself. We've got things to do.
Look, I can appreciate why you've come round here, but you've got to look at this from Tim's point of view as well. Me and him are dead close, and he probably thought he was just helping me out.
Oh, by threatening a child. You've taught him well, haven't you?
What's that supposed to mean?
He was that far from going for Kevin when I turned up. God knows what would have happened if I hadn't have interrupted them.
Hey, you should have got on to the busies, love.
Yeah, all right, Jimmy.
I would have done if I thought it would do some good. But let's face it, Tim's had enough to deal with these last 3 years. I don't blame him.
Hang on, what are you getting at?
I think I've made myself clear enough.
Oh, where are you going, love? I was just going to put the kettle on there.
Jimmy, will you just do one for 5 minutes, please?
Yeah, sure.
Don't go on my account. I've said everything I came to say.
Are you implying that I abused Tim?
I don't know what you've done.
Hang on, don't just walk away. I want to talk to you.
Save your lies for the courtroom.
Just listen, will you?
Get you off me.
Look, for your information, Andrew's the one that's lying, and it's his brother that's put him up to it.
You're disgusting.
Oh, it's true. I know it. Just open your eyes.
I hope they throw away the key.
Will you just talk to him or let me talk to him?
You've already ruined one child's life. Now you want to start on another.
I haven't done anything.
You stay away from them, do you hear? That's the last time I'm going to say that. Next time you or any of your cronies come anywhere near those boys, I'm going straight to the police.
Can I help you?
No.
Then do you mind going to stare at someone else?
I'm not staring.
Then what are you doing?
Killing time.
What?
My lodger wants a bit of privacy. Some woman's called round to see him.
Oh, right, I see.
So, what is it you're doing, then?
Homework.
Oh, right. Any good?
No.
Why, what is it?
History. I hate history.
Hey, history's sound.
Not in our school.
Why, what school's that?
Brookside Comp.
Oh, right. What year?
10.
10? Karen Dalton, eh?
How do you know?
I used to work with her.
Doing what?
Teaching history.
I thought you were a glass collector.
Yeah, I am now. So what is it you're doing exactly?
Darren, will you put your work away?
I know, yeah. I'm knackered just looking at them.
Some of us can't afford to laze around, isn't that right, Katie?
We've been washed off our feet all day.
Yeah, which is why you should take a break in the evening.
Yeah, not much to go now. Look, do you fancy going round to the bar for a drink later on?
Oh, sorry, I can't. I'm going round to Susanna's.
Susanna Morrissey?
Yep.
Why?
For a drink, a chat and a bit of a gossip.
Didn't know you and Susanna were mates, Vic.
No, well, we're not really, but we had a coffee together the other day and she invited me round.
She's not your type.
And how would you know?
I just don't think she is all.
Actually, she's very nice. I was surprised. I always thought she was a bit of a stiff.
Do you reckon she'd be interested in joining my club?
Hmm? What?
Oh, haven't you heard? This one's organising a slimming club.
Wow. I'm impressed.
Body-wise. Jane Fonda at your heart, I'll say. Welcome to join, if you like.
Yeah. Well, I might well do, actually. I could do with losing some pounds. What do you think? Do you fancy it?
No, I don't think so. Look, are you sure you won't change your mind about tonight?
No, Darren, I can't. I've made arrangements now.
You know what? I think you're going to get loads of people, you know.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, everyone wants to lose weight, don't they?
Where are you going to hold the classes, Katie?
Well, I haven't actually got a venue yet. I was thinking maybe the health club.
My health club?
Well, you've got that big dance studio, haven't you?
Well, yeah, as long as everyone pays the membership.
What?
Well, it's members only, isn't it?
You're talking nearly 400 quid a time.
Yeah, I know, but in case it's a private club, I can't just let anyone in, can I? I'd be losing fortunes.
So you're saying no? You're not going to let me use it?
What? How can I? It doesn't make sense.
Well, thanks, Jack.
Oh, Casey, come on.
Nice to know who your friends are.
See you later.
The depression. I mean, that just says it all, doesn't it?
No, it's really interesting, this.
Crap.
Aye, aye, missy, mind the language.
Picked history to learn about people that matter, not a load of saddos on the dole.
Now, come on, I'm not having that. These people had principles. They were prepared to stand up and be counted, not like the load of deadheads we got hanging around these days.
Doesn't sound like they did anything except moan about not having a job.
What? These people were incredible. They got together and made the fat cats of this country listen. They would have given their lives for the principles.
Oh, yeah?
They bloody would.
Now who's swearing?
Listen, has no one ever told you about the storming of the Walker Art Gallery?
No.
Oh, Adele, I don't believe it. What are they teaching you in that school? That was when having principles meant something.
Why? What did they do?
I'll tell you what. How'd you fancy going into town, doing a little bit of research of your own?
How do you mean?
Well, you know, get a few books on local history, see what you can find on the Walker Art Gallery.
I don't know. It's never been mentioned in any of the lessons.
Yeah, well, it should have been. Because I'll tell you something. It's a hell of a lot more important than this load of crap.
What are you wearing that for?
What?
Well, you're going to a gay club, aren't you? You look the same as you always look.
Oh, don't sound so disappointed.
You go for a drink before?
Yeah, I suppose so.
You nervous?
No, why should I be?
Can I ask you a question?
What?
How come you switched?
How do you mean?
Well, one minute you're going through fellas like there's no tomorrow, and the next thing you're heading off to the Isle of Lesbos.
I don't know.
Well, something must have happened to make you change your mind.
Shelley, I suppose.
But why? I mean, don't get me wrong, I love the bones of Shelley, but it doesn't make me want to get me kit off and hop on board.
Well, I've hardly had any luck with the men I've had relationships with, so maybe that's got something to do with it.
Maybe you just haven't met the right fella, yeah? I mean, look at me and my Dave.
Hey, no man can be trusted.
He can, otherwise I wouldn't be marrying him.
Right, you ready to go? Yeah.
Look at her, she looks petrified. You wouldn't think she was going for a night out.
Any second thoughts?
No, no.
No, ready for action, aren't you, Lindsay? You and 500 lezzers.
Come on then, see you later, Bev.
See ya.
See ya.
Oh, do everything I wouldn't do.
I was, but I'm having a nightmare trying to find somewhere to have it.
Well, what's wrong with Jackie's place? She's got all the gear and everything.
Yeah, but she said no.
What?
Well, she said yeah, but everyone who joins would have to pay the £400 membership fee.
The tight cow!
I suppose she's got to earn her money somehow.
Well, I'm sorry, but I've got 2 stone to lose, and I'm not letting that Jackie mingebag Dixon stop me. Can I have it at my place?
What?
Yeah, at the bar. Be all right, we'll just push some tables back.
Are you sure?
Yeah, positive. Give us a call when you know what is going on. Tra.
Tra.
What am I going to do, Jimmy? I'm finished.
Has Jackie been clearing stuff out of here?
I mean, what else can I do? Like everything's run away with itself. It's all got out of control, and I can't do anything to stop it.
Where's all my books?
What?
All my school books, they've all gone.
Is that all you've got to say?
I need to look something up.
Jimmy, my life's on the line here. I'm in court for something I didn't do. I'll probably end up in prison, and you're bleating on about books.
Little girl next door needs a hand with her homework.
Wake up and smell the coffee, Jimmy. You're not a teacher anymore. In fact, you never were in the first place. You were a fraud who conned his way into school for 5 minutes and hasn't shut up about it since. Jimmy. Jimmy, where are you going? Jimmy!
What about you? Have you got a man in your life at the moment?
I wish.
Come on, there must be someone.
No, there isn't, honestly.
I thought you and Darren...
Not at the moment, no.
So there's no chance of you two getting back together again?
I don't know. If only life was that easy.
Stick to the wine.
White?
Yeah.
You okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
Good. See you in a minute.
See ya. Take it easy. This is my third glass in about 10 minutes.
There's plenty more in the fridge.
I get really maudlin when I get drunk. I'll probably end up in tears on your front step.
I didn't know you felt so strongly about him.
Oh, I don't know. We're just one of those couples. Can't live with him, can't live without him. When we were together, all we did was fight.
But you get on now.
Yeah, that's the frustrating thing.
Why ruin a good thing? If I were you, I'd put the romance behind me and just get on as friends.
Darren probably wouldn't be interested in me now anyway, after the way I treated him.
Well, you tried it as a couple. It didn't work. You know, I just move on. Find someone else.
Bev's bar, well, how much is she charging?
Nothing. She's given us it for free, so I don't need your health club thanks. And you know what? I made up, because the last thing I wanted to do was scab off you. You'd never let me forget it.
Hang on, I've just said you can use the health club, haven't I?
For a price. That says it all. Everything you do is for money, Jackie. You're obsessed.
Sorry to bother you at home, Dad.
Oh, how did you get up here?
Someone let me in on the way out. I need to speak to you. I need some more tabs.
You've still got a couple of weeks worth left, haven't you?
I dropped them down the park.
You what?
Well, I knocked them off the system. You know, it was an accident.
Look, if you're after a consultation, you'll have to come into the surgery tomorrow.
No. Please, I'm desperate.
This is my home. It's not some sort of all-night drop-in centre.
You're the only one I could turn to.
All right, you better come in.
What's going on over there?
Oh, someone on the dance floor, I think.
Actually, I definitely know him from somewhere. Hey, he works in Bev's bar. Go on, go for it, lads!
Hello?
Liz?
Oh, we're supposed to be telling anybody.
Oh, Lance won't tell anyone. He works in the bar.
Lesbian, I'm all. When did you two become an item?
So it's been a couple of days since you've taken anything.
Yeah.
And how are you feeling? Tired?
Yeah, knackered.
Dizzy spells?
Yeah, all the time. Yeah, it's spinning.
Yeah, well, that will be because you've stopped suddenly instead of gradually reducing the dose.
You think I should go back on them?
Yes, I would if I were you.
Okay, Doc.
Look, I'll write you another prescription.
Ta.
There's an all-night chemist up the road.
Yeah, it's all right. I know where it is.
Can I ask one favour? Next time, can you use the walk-in centre?
Yeah. No probs, Doc.
Gorgeous.
Thing is, not that many people know.
What? That she's gone over to the other side?
That Lindsay and I are together.
Oh, go away.
Well, it's me, actually. It felt weird at first, but I'm starting...
We'd prefer if you didn't tell anybody, Lance.
I am starting to get used to it now.
Yeah, but we still don't want anybody else to know.
Don't worry, babe. Your secret's safe with me. Cross me heart, hope to die. I'll see you later. This is my favourite song.
I am starting to get used to it now. Maybe we should start telling people.
I still think it's too soon, then.
Do you reckon?
We've only been going out for a few weeks. Let's just see how it goes, yeah?
Shelley?
Paula?
What are you doing here?
Socialising, same as you.
Oh, my God. You two are together.
We have been for ages.
I finally got what you wanted then, eh?
Yeah, I did, actually.
Oh, I'm surprised at you, though, Shell. I thought it was the mother you were after.
These come this morning. Thought I'd bring them round.
That's funny. I was going to pop over to see you tonight.
Yeah, I'll come.
What's this about you going to see Barbara?
What do you know about?
I had her round here today going off her head. I told you, it's nothing to do with you.
Told them not to go.
What am I meant to do? Just sit back and do nothing?
And what are you going to achieve by threatening some kid?
Make him tell the truth?
Oh, here we go. The big man's going to wade in and sort them all out with his fists.
You're going to get yourself into trouble.
That's exactly what I told him.
I don't care.
Well, I do. Look, I don't want you anywhere near Barbara or either of them two lads until this lot's over, right? Right? I mean it, Tim. You're only going to make matters worse.
Yeah, okay.
Lee, I'm going to Susanna's. See you in the morning, okay?
See you later.
Let's see. My God. Did this come to mix?
Yeah, I'll give us the rest of them. I don't want to see things like that.
I wonder how many of these he's had.
Look, if I would have known what it was, I would have brought it round.
Doesn't matter. I'm going to have to get used to an aren't I being labelled a pervert.
I don't say that.
What's the point, Tim? It's true, isn't it, eh? That's what everybody thinks. And once it gets to court and in the papers, I'm going to get dissed by the sackload, aren't I?
You fancy me, Mum?
I've heard everything now.
I don't know where you dredged up that idea, Paula.
I'm right, aren't I?
Have you met Lindsay's mum?
She's the last person on earth she'd fancy.
She's really not my type.
Oh, right. I must have got it wrong then.
Yeah, you have.
Sorry, I didn't mean to upset anyone.
Don't worry about it. Mum will laugh her head off when she finds out. She'll find it hilarious.
There's not really any need to tell her, Lindsay.
Oh, why not? I'm sure Lindsay's mum's game for a laugh. I take it she knows you two are an item. Well, actually...
Linds, I don't mean to ruin the night, but do you mind if we go home?
It's just starting to get going. Oh, don't run off. Stay and chat.
I've got a really bad headache.
Are you OK?
No, actually. Nice to see you.
You haven't changed, Paula.
I've got some paracetamol in me, I'm back. Shelley, hang on. Keep in touch.
And that's it. They're not going to try and find the get-to, did they?
Well,
I'm going to show this lot round here. On our wedding day, I am going to be like a stick.
Today's the day.
What again?
We've got to make the most of this chance.
Perhaps it'd be better if I let them get me.
No, you've got to fight back.
An amazing 48 hours in the Big Brother house and four talks exclusively to the infamous Nick next. Plus, still time to vote for this week's eviction. All in a specially extended live program coming up.
Cheers, mate.
No problem.
So what are they going to do?
Reckons we should put a guard over the letterbox.
And that's it? They're not going to try and find the get-to, did they?
Well, they're not very hopeful. It's obviously a gang after Sinbad, but hardly narrows down the suspects.
But we all could have been killed.
One thing for sure, our Gemma's not coming here. I'll phone you, Mum.
What? And tell her that someone tries to burn down the house?
I think I'll edit that bit out. You okay now, son?
No, I'm not okay. It's lucky we changed the batteries in the smoke detector, otherwise we'd have all been dead.
What happens next day? What are they gonna try next?
Good
You look like you're enjoying that. Thought the depression was getting you down.
I found something interesting. Storming at the Walker Art Gallery.
When did that happen?
1921. A group of unemployed men stormed in and took it over.
Never heard of that. Hey, pop over the garage and get these for us, will you?
So I have to.
Morning, love. Hey, you know the season starts Sunday after next. I've had a rethink.
And what have you rethunk?
I reckon Tower Park's at its dog days.
You're not giving up the footy. You've just got all your new players.
No. What I reckon is, we should start again from scratch. Give Manor Park a side all of its own. I mean, well, we live miles away from the other place, so I'm going to seek out the lads and put it to them. Maybe get some new strips. Ask somebody for some sponsorship.
You do remember what day it is today, don't you?
You're starting Katie Doudar's Slimming Club today, aren't you? If you needed it.
It's the 22nd, the peak of my fertility. And it's your day off.
Great. Well, I look forward to it then.
The kids have gone. There's nothing to stop us trying now.
Well, don't you think you ought to finish the dishes?
All right, sir.
The busies have just been over. Are you okay?
Yeah. Leo's taking the day off. He still feels a bit shaky, you know. He's the one who put the fire out.
Leo? What can I say?
Do you want to come in?
No, Tar. I just came over to make sure you two were all right.
Listen, son. I know we fell out on that, but please don't think that we blame you for any of this.
You what?
Well, it's obvious what happened. They must have thought you were still living here.
And you don't blame me?
Well, like I said, no, not at all.
Well, thanks, pal. Thanks a lot.
I don't get you.
Somebody tried to kill me last night, and you don't blame me for the idiot pouring petrol through your letterbox, big man.
You can't take it like that.
Save your sympathy for somebody that needs it.
Mr. Corkill.
Hello.
Hiya. I've just been reading that topic idea you gave me on the march on the Walker Art Gallery. You know, the police had a tip-off and they hid in the Sessions House, which was the building next door. Then they raided it. There was a riot. Yeah.
The government was terrified of any Labour movement so soon after the Russian Revolution.
Which was October 1917.
Very good. Mind you, what would I know anyway? In my executive position of dead bevy collected and picking up a WhatsApp packet.
Yeah, but you were a teacher.
Was.
Hard, I'm sorry if I've upset you. It must be dead hard.
No, used to be. One thing I've learned is the depression's really just a chemical state.
How do you mean?
Well, if you're down for whatever reason, it's just because your brain's not making enough serotonin, so you take a pill. And it makes it all work.
You want pills, and they work.
Yeah. They help me face the world. Something I couldn't do before.
I could never do that. I mean, I know it's a matter of individual choice, but it's like cutting off all your emotions. How do you know how you're really feeling?
Well, they help you get better.
Or it takes the edge off you. If you can't cry, if you can't grieve, isn't it just another way of controlling people? Give them a little happiness pills.
Yeah, well, so long as I'm happy, I don't care.
I can't believe it. How anyone could be so stupid, it wasn't even the right house.
Just thank God that you and Leo got out of there.
What was going through their heads, eh? They don't even know Sibbet. They don't know a thing about him.
Calm down. It won't happen again.
We don't know that. What happens if they do the homework next time, eh? What happens if they get him?
They won't.
It all comes back to the Kevin lad, doesn't it? He's the one behind all this.
You're not saying that he pushed that rag through the door, are you?
Might as well have been, though. Because as long as he's lying, Sinbad and all the rest of us can't get on with our lives.
So, if the alarm hadn't gone off, Tim and Leo would have ended up in flames?
Doesn't it make you want to rage? People setting themselves up as judge, jury, and executioner. Oh.
You all right, lover?
Oh, it's my knees. They're killing me. I was out last night. Necked three of them breezes. Then my mate Clayton says, let's get on the podium. Oh. Well, they only went and played Madonna, Steps and Britney one after the other. Oh, my knees.
Where'd you go?
Oh, Sapphire and Steel's.
Where?
Oh, it's a gay place.
Or just fellas?
No, mixed.
Oh, women as well. Only, I might know some people who were there last night and all.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, some people we both know.
I don't think we should be going there.
A certain flatmate of mine.
Say it to the hand, babe, because the face ain't listening.
Hey, Bev. I've got some stuff to set up for the club. Can I use your muscle?
Yeah, go on.
Oh, thanks again for letting me use the bar.
I'm not above myself like certain other friends of yours, Katie.
Yeah, I heard about that Jackie Dixon wanting to charge us all. And here, you're busy, mate. God, the nerve that woman's got.
Katie, guess what I have for breakfast? Half a grapefruit, one slice of toast, Marmite, no spread, and coffee, no sugar.
Well done. That's a great start.
Keep telling her she needn't bother. She's perfect as she is.
Well, it's about all around fitness, not just changing the way you eat. You can both come along if you want. There's nothing to stop men coming in.
Oh, I really am perfect as I am.
I'm terrible, me. I guzzle like a Guinness, but I don't put a thing on. Just get yourself sorted.
Really, you don't have to bother. I saw you this morning. That grapefruit was a real battle for you.
When I set my mind to something, I'm going to show this lot round here. On our wedding day, I am going to be like a stick.
I couldn't leave it like that. Go on, tell me you're sorry like you'd always do.
My house was attacked. My son could have been killed. It was a terrible thing. Can't I be forgiven for not thinking straight?
It is a terrible thing. The latest in a long line.
I want to be a mate again, Sin. You've always been right there at my side, and all this is doing my head in.
I was always there. Till it turned out you couldn't even trust me with your own son. Now this happens and you blame me.
I didn't mean it like that, not in a bad way. It's the way it came out of my mouth.
Go on, admit it. When you saw that fire last night, what was the first thing that came into your head? Sinbad's fault.
No.
You expect me to feel guilty? Well, I don't. I'm innocent of everything. And I'm sorry for what happened to Leo last night, and I am so glad that he's okay, but it had nothing to do with me, mate. There are some sick people out there who want aggro, and they'll use any excuse. They're the ones to blame, not me.
Look, I still mean what I say. You know, if there's anything we can get out of this, can't we be mates again, Sin?
And how long till I get the blame again? Me and my friend's pretty tough at the moment, and I just don't think you're up to it.
There, what did I tell you? 8 stone 2¾ pounds, forever and ever. Amen.
How often do you take exercise?
Oh, whenever Matt Damon asks me for a date.
Because I have a high cholesterol level or something.
Oh, girl, don't rain on me parade.
Oh, doesn't it look professional?
Thanks. I want to collect a bit more stuff, so see you at 12:30.
See ya.
Yeah, never finished telling me gossip, did I?
I know.
What's that supposed to mean?
I saw Lindsay and Shelley in the club last night, and they were pretty keen to keep it a secret. Made me swear.
Same here.
So, best we keep the secret, eh? And leave them to it.
It's only you, though.
I better get back behind the bar.
Oh, hiya.
I'm just taking my lunch. How are you?
Happy as a sand boy.
Oh, yeah.
As well as can be expected, actually.
Have they caught them that did it?
No, not yet.
Probably never will. Do you know what? The busies love the lynch mob. Someone doing the job for them. No. No.
Jimmy! Jimmy! Jimmy, what the hell are you doing?
My pills. Where are my pills? Where are they?
Slim Club, are we?
Oh, I am. The doctor's told me to get my blood pressure down. I'm already off the salt. I've asked Ray to hide it from me.
Oh, hiya.
Hiya. You know me, Mum.
I'm just here to keep Diane company. I have tried every diet conceived by man. I've never so much as lost half a pound.
Afternoon, ladies. Sit yourselves down.
What's she going to know about dieting? She's like a little bird. Probably because she's got the right diet.
Thanks for coming along. Now, the most important thing to remember is that a healthy diet is only part of the equation. Exercise for fitness is an essential. Think of your body like it's a car. You've got to put the right fuel in to get peak performance.
She's lost
now,
me already.
Now, I want you to think of this programme as a long, straight road. Now, if you take a slight detour, you don't go careering off your route. You turn round, get back on the road and put the pedal down. And remember, along this road, there's going to be lots of tempting parking spaces.
I thought this was a slimming club. I feel as if I've joined the AA.
Shh. I'm trying to listen.
Right, let me go through the basics.
Yeah. Jackie moved them this morning. She saw Kylie playing in here. She didn't want to take in any.
Why didn't she tell me?
She didn't get a chance. Are you okay?
Yeah.
I better start clearing all this back, hadn't I?
All right, I'm okay.
Now, I asked Bev to keep a food diary over the last few days so I can give you a few pointers. Bev, can you read the extract we agreed?
Sure. Sunday lunch. Dave opts for the traditional roast with spuds and gravy. Am tempted, but remember Katie's club about to start, and so tuck into jacket potato with baked beans, no butter, and so using the beans to moisturise.
Can I stop you there? You see, you had that same meal 2 days running.
Yeah, but it's low fat though, isn't it?
Yeah. But hidden sugars can be a real sting in the tail. Like this tin of baked beans. Very low fat, low in salt, but guess how much sugar it contains. Equivalent to 15 chocolate eclairs.
So we can't even eat that thrilling repast without feeling guilty.
Once a week, but you really need to keep variety in your diet.
But Bev's jacket potato was all right, surely?
Very good, but as I say, Bev, try to vary, because if you eat a lot of spuds, their carbohydrate content can be stored as fat. Carry on.
I had a glass of water and then finished off with a low fat from our tray.
Again, that's very good, but watch out for two things. Drinking water is great, but if you drink while eating, it can flush out a lot of the minerals and vitamins you get from your food. And fromage fraise is nice, but bear in mind it's a very processed food, and it's always better, if you can, to use fresh ingredients.
Flamin' heck. Sounds like there's nothing we can't eat.
Food should be a pleasure, not a pain. As long as you keep a balanced diet, you can't go wrong. Now, I'll just get up the scales and we'll mark up our starting weights. And remember, this isn't a competition. Our bodies are all different, so we'll lose weight at different rates.
You never said anything about this. Of course you've got to get on the scales, Mum. And you said you were the same weight you ever were. That's as may be, but I don't want this lot knowing the exact mathematics.
All right. Hi, mate. Have you got a minute?
Yeah.
I'm thinking of starting up a new Manor Park side for the Sunday League. Young Tim's already signed up.
What are you looking at me for?
What do you think?
I think my footy days are over.
No way. You're a big athletic lad. I need to see Leo.
Yeah, go through, son.
Faces on you lot today.
Didn't you hear what happened last night? Someone poured petrol through the letterbox.
Oh, you're joking. Why? Your mate Sinbad. Why the hell would somebody do something like that? I don't understand it.
Haven't you ever watched the news? Seen something like this happen, you know, some brave citizen having a go, and you thought to yourself, well done, mate.
But this is different.
Because we know Sinbad, and we know he's innocent. If this was going on somewhere else to someone else, wouldn't we be cheering him on now?
But what if they come back tonight?
Leo, they won't. They know you're going to be expecting them.
Yeah, it's easy enough for you to say. You ain't here when it happened. And neither was me daddy, never is.
So what, you're getting lonely now? I thought you were the big man.
Yes, I am getting lonely. My dad's always round at Susanna's. Tim's always with Emily. I wish you'd move back in with us.
Me? You know I would. Ray's old mum's cracking me up, but I'm not going anywhere without Nikki, and she's going nowhere near Susanna. And you know what happened to her in this house?
Yeah, but can't you persuade her? I mean, seriously, Jerome, I'm gonna go mad staying in here by myself with no one to speak to.
Last time she bit me head off. Listen, mate, I'll try. And anyway, if worse comes to worse, I guess you could always move in with your Cheryl.
No chance. Don't want to face her all, man.
Sorry, mate. Oh, no.
I just wanted you to know how bad I feel about it.
Thanks.
So what are you going to do about it?
Well, what can I do? What can the busies do?
Sin, someone tried to kill you.
I was expecting it. After that brick came through the window, after the petition, I knew there'd be something else. I was kind of looking forward to it. Perhaps I'd be better if I let them get me.
No, you've got to fight back.
No point. Probably be safer inside, eh?
You're not going down. That's the one thing you've got to hold on to.
I'm just waiting now.
No! You didn't do it. We know it was Andrew's brother who put him up to it.
You stay away from them.
We've got to do something.
Look, one thing I've learned from this is that when anyone tries to make things better, they only make it worse.
Can't stand to see you like this.
I'm going to be fine. You look after yourself, son. You have a good life. Look after yourself the way everybody else does. Because it was trying to help other people that got me here. And that's going to take me to jail. That was my life. And if they get me, that's the one lesson I want the whole world to learn from it.
Look, mate, I've been exactly where you are now. And when I say exactly, I mean exactly.
I don't want to talk about it. And you won't either, to anyone, if you want to keep your little job.
I know. And I mean, I know exactly. I was an addict.
Well, that's where we differ, because I'm not, never have, never will be.
That's what I said. I didn't want to admit the damage that stuff was doing to me. But I was lucky. I got out before it was too late.
Yeah, well, thanks for the community services announcement, Jimmy. But the only harm it does me is hit me in the wallet.
Dave, when you listen to yourself, hear your words and compare them to what you're feeling inside, in here. Oh, mate, you've got a good job. You've got a good woman. Don't throw it all away. You've got to kick it while you can. While you can still claim there's nothing wrong.
I didn't ask for your advice. Will you let me get past?
Dave, it's the best advice you're going to get. And I'm not some leaflet or some tosser of a politician that doesn't know what he's talking about. I know. I've been there.
I'm doing this because I've had a bad time, and this will get me through it. I do it when I choose. I'm in control of it. I don't have an addictive personality.
So what is it you're saying?
Not my problem if you can't handle your drugs, Jimmy. Now remember what I said. Mouth shut.
Seems a bit harsh to me, this regime she's cooked up.
I'm sure it makes perfect sense. But frankly, I live for me treats.
May I be just as frank?
Mum.
I think it's a perfect load of rubbish. Potatoes never hurt anybody.
Oh, I don't know. I gained £2 a week, you know. All I ate was taters.
As if you can trust weighing scales. A pint of water weighs a pound and a quarter, my mother used to say.
Anyway, girls, we don't start officially until tomorrow, so why not bid a fond farewell to the fairest potato of them all?
Why not? And final splurge.
Mum, I'm going to find Marty.
Right, see you back at the house.
OK, but give it a while, will you?
Oh, is she?
Gotcha. Is that Katie's idea of a healthy diet?
No. It's my idea of getting ahead of the race.
I've said I'm sorry. I don't know what else I can do.
He'll come round when all this blows over.
Nah, I don't think I can ever make it up to him. Whatever I say is the wrong thing.
Oh, you got Leo to look after. You got your own life to lead. And you're getting married. This is a whole new start.
Yeah, but me and Sam, he never saw us, mate. He's the best friend I ever had. He really is a brother to me.
Are you sure he couldn't have done it?
Positive. I know him better than I know myself.
I suppose I've judged him without even really knowing him. Just like them thugs did last night. He seems like a nice guy, but why would a kid lie?
That's the question.
Hiya.
Hi.
There's what happened. Glad to see you're okay, Mick.
Thanks, Dad.
Marty, you said you'd come home for your dinner.
Yeah, me and Mick are chatting.
It is important.
Look, you go ahead. Don't you get into trouble.
All right. Cheers, mate.
Yeah, Marty.
What's the hurry?
You know, today's the day.
What again?
We've got to make the most of this chance.
I'm sorry. Just can't get around my head what's happening to Sinbad.
He told you there's nothing you can do.
So we're all just meant to sit back and let him go down for it? When we all know it's that Kevin kid's pack of lies. He done a lot for me, you know him. I just treated him bad back in return. But I'm telling you, he's a good man. He's the best. The most decent fella I've ever met. Nobody deserves a false accusation, especially not him. He helps people. He wants what's best for other people.
It's awful, but what can you do?
I don't know. But if I don't do something, I know he'll top himself.
You're joking.
And if he does, I'll never forgive myself for just doing nothing.
Look, you tried your best with Kevin. It didn't work.
Well, then I'll go back.
Now?
You'll only be getting yourself into trouble and you won't be helping Sinbad.
How can things get any worse for Sinbad, eh? I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna get the truth out of that little scumbag, even if I have to kill him.
I must stink after them bees.
I don't care.
Yeah, but what if we have a baby with buzzard breath?
What's wrong?
I just keep thinking about Sinbad. Mick's convinced he never touched that kid. I mean, you know, really and truly can't believe it.
So what? Mick's his mate.
Doesn't that count for anything? I mean, we don't know Sinbad from Adam, but Mick's known him for years.
Whenever they catch these people, the friends always stick up for them.
So friendship doesn't count? If someone accused me, you'd stick up for me.
Of course.
Yeah, but anybody who didn't know us, they'd just say what you did. That she was just sticking up for her old man.
The big difference being that you haven't been accused. Are you okay?
Yeah. Her drinks just made me a bit sleepy, that's all. Sorry. Can we do this a bit later?
We can't miss the opportunity.
No, it's just that I thought, you know, after the barbecue, things might be a bit more spontaneous.
We've got to. A flaming football team or having a drink with
Mick.
I
know. I know.
I don't need you. I don't need any substance. A new start. That's what happens to drugs in this house. A new start. A new start.
So you've nowhere to stay at all?
No, I'm an orphan of the storm.
You're not going to blackmail me.
We'll see.
Well, what do you want? A word with you.
Get in there. This is the first time Austin's invited anybody back here.
Oh, Mum?
I'm really sorry to bother you, but it's all answer.
Yes, of course. Come in.
All that's in store tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Next up, making the life jacket better by design could give more people the chance of survival. Richard Seymour and Dick Powell take up the challenge here on 4.
Post you, hurry up and get here.
Why do you care the my results?
Because we've got business later on, remember?
Oh, you're not still going on about that, are you?
Too right I am. Look, that little get Kevin started all this. And now we've got petrol coming through our letterbox.
It wasn't him.
Yeah, well, it might as well have been. He needs sorting before Sinbad does something stupid.
Would you fancy restocking the lager when you finish with that?
Yeah, no props.
You all right, babe? You look a bit peaky.
Yeah, just a bit dizzy. Be all right in a minute.
So what are we going to do?
Well, I suppose we could try sneaking back into the squad.
There's no way I'm setting foot in that place again. Not after they voted you out like that. And anyway, they changed the locks.
Well, we're going to have to find somewhere else then, aren't we?
Well, it'll have to be cheap. We're hardly Brewsters, are we?
Well, don't worry. I've got an idea where I can get my hands on some cash.
Well, Joba.
Can't you use the bathroom?
And have you gotten at me for getting grease everywhere?
Very thoughtful. So, how are things with Katrina?
Fine.
I was thinking you might want to invite her around for a tea.
Not my dad skip me the whole time. I don't think so.
I'll make sure he behaves himself.
I don't know, it's still a bit early for all that, meeting the family stuff.
There's no time like the present. The longer you put it off, the more awkward it's going to be.
I'll think about it.
Think about what?
Nothing.
Steve's thinking of asking Trina around for a tea.
As in Trona and her magnificent tots.
See, he started already.
No, he's not. Are you?
Absolutely not. She's more than welcome, isn't she, Aunt?
Effa?
She won't go skip me then if I do ask around.
Would we do a thing like that?
Go on then, open it. I can't. You open it for me.
No. It's not blind date, you know.
Don't sweat it, Em. Whatever result you get, it's bound to be better than Tim's because he had more ease than an all-nighter.
Here we go, then. Come on. So? Three C's and an A.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Never had you down for a swat, Em.
Well, take any notice of him. What'd you get an A for? Religious studies.
Oh, no wonder you got an A. That's got to be the doziest subject ever.
Come on, can we go now?
Oh, are you going to wait for me now to come back? She's only gone to the shops. She's going to be made up. Oh, no, I promised him I'd go to town.
Oh, well, see you later.
See ya.
Just goes to prove what I've always thought.
What's that?
Qualifications these days. Not worth the paper they're printed on.
So you've nowhere to stay at all?
No, I'm an orphan of the storm.
Have you any family?
Oh, just Charlie Amble. She's in the same boat.
Well, what will you do tonight in that case?
Nothing.
Sleep on the streets?
Sure, I'll find a shop doorway somewhere.
Why don't you go to one of them hostels?
Oh, no, they're a bit rough, aren't they?
Well, you'd be all right if you had your Leanne with you. They'd all be too scared to come near you.
Leave our Leanne out of this.
Oh, why? What are you going to do? Get her to beat me up, like?
Talk to the hand, Ron.
Well, if you don't find anywhere, you let me know.
Oh, thanks.
You're not thinking of letting that one stay at yours, I hope.
You put me up once.
That was different.
Have you been finishing off the empties?
No, I went a bit dizzy then. I must have tripped. Top.
I'll have a word with you later.
About what?
My shift.
Shouldn't you be asking Bev?
Oh, I wouldn't worry about her. She won't get anything past June.
I'll make sure she doesn't.
Shake a leg, honey.
You what?
I thought you might give us a hand with this.
Oh, we thought wrong then, didn't you?
Suit yourself. But if I drop dead with overexertion, I hope you'll be able to live with yourself.
If only.
I heard that.
This must be your lucky day, Steve. There's Trona, and she's on her own.
So? When are you going to ask her around?
That was me mum's idea.
I'll ask her for you, if you like.
Here, Trine, ask Steve wants a word.
Thanks a million.
Don't mention it, son.
So, what do you say?
Well, it'd be better than sleeping outdoors.
It's really nice of you, but I can't leave our Leanne to fend for herself.
I'm afraid putting the two of you up would be a bit of a squeeze. You see, I need one of the bedrooms free for when Harry and Emma come to stay.
Oh, I understand.
That was a close one, Maxie.
And I was to ask if there's anything you don't eat.
No, I don't think so. Why might we have it?
Curry, with that little rice stuff, couscous, I think it's called.
I think you'll find it's pronounced cuckoo. It's French.
Oh, you're going to think we're a right bunch of myths.
Don't be daft. I've just travelled a bit, that's all.
What now?
We wait. He can't hide in there all day, can he?
Why would I want to go sponsoring the local team? Don't know the first thing about footy.
You don't have to. I mean, I take care of that side of things.
Well, I don't want to sound half-faced, but what do I get out of it?
Well, you'd be helping the local community, for one thing.
Well, if I wanted to do that, I'd just lower the price of the ale.
But I tell you what, you can have your name on the strip. I mean, companies pay millions for that.
Not for Manor Park United or whatever it is you call yourselves. Besides, I've seen your strip. I don't want my name plastered on there.
What's wrong with it?
Well, it's a bit 70s, isn't it? You're expecting just to sprout sideboards and big muzzies.
All right, then, tell you what. You can choose a new strip, any colour you fancy.
Go on, then. Hey, but on one condition.
What's that?
Well, your team do the drinking in here when they've had the match and they wear the shorts while they're at it.
Oh, she drives a hard bargain.
Done. How'd you get on?
She's coming round tonight.
Nice one. Looks like it's 2-0 to the Murrays. Bev's agreed to sponsor the team.
Don't go worrying about me.
Are you sure?
Like I said, by tonight I'm going to be boxed off. Go on. Go ahead and move in with Max.
Well, I'll see if I can catch him up now. Can you cover for me?
Of course.
Hey, just think. I'm going to be living with a celeb.
Listen to that.
What? Can't hear anything?
Exactly. She must have gone out.
Oh, for a quick lie down in a coffin.
Maybe we should go and screw it down for her then.
Don't know why my nan just doesn't tell her to sling a hook.
You know what? I wish she would. Maybe then we'd get our room back.
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing about these modern houses. The walls are paper thin.
We thought you'd gone out.
Don't worry, I'm not going anywhere. Not till I can get my Raymond out of this den of iniquity.
What time do you want me around then?
Well, any time, really.
And don't worry, I won't be any bother. In fact, you won't even know I'm there.
You haven't. Well, not that it's any of your business. Yes, he had nowhere to go.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you.
Do you know, you really are beyond the limit sometimes, just because Lance happens to be gay.
It's nothing to do with him being one of them. His sister almost blinded our Jackie, remember?
If you could.
Right, that's him on his own.
How do you know he's even in there?
Because I saw him at the window before. Come on.
We don't have anywhere else to go. And this place, it doesn't pay us enough to get somewhere.
So you want some more shifts?
Oh, not exactly.
I thought that's what this was about.
That's part of it, yeah?
Get to the point, Leanne.
Does Bev know that you're still a druggie?
I'm not. That's all in the past.
Come off it, I've seen you.
Then you must be imagining things.
Oh, like you at Bev's party with a tenner stuffed up your hooter. I don't think so.
Big deal, so I have the odd line. It's not a capital offence.
Well, it isn't Bev's book, and I don't think she'd be too pleased if she found out.
She's not going to find out, though, is she?
Well, that depends.
You wouldn't dare.
Try me.
Sit down. OK. Spit it out. If it's not more shifts, what do you want?
500.
I haven't got that kind of money.
Then you better find it then, hadn't you?
Or?
Or your cushy little number with Beverly is well and truly finito.
You're not going to blackmail me.
We'll see.
Oh, that was quick.
Oh, Bev, let me store my stuff behind the bar.
All right.
Oh, she's the saint, that woman. Goodness shines out of her, like an aura.
Do you want a hand with the upper lock?
No, you're all right. She's suffered at the hands of that Ron Dixon, you know. Made her life merry hell. What, you hear Bev complaining? No, you don't. She's a bit like Harley Ann in that way.
In what way?
Wronged. I mean, if I was Ron Dixon, I wouldn't show my face. Mind you, they're all brass-necked in that family. Look at the daughter.
Well, Jackie.
Well, I know you two are friendly, but I can't abide her. I'll have to make myself scarce if she calls round.
No, I don't think that'll
be. Mike's so nice, I suppose, though. He's deathly dull. Oh, see more life in a laboratory slide.
Right, well, shall we get you moved in?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Let me go on and on. Probably got a million and one things to do. Oh, I'm looking forward to a bit of peace and quiet myself after that squat was murder.
How come?
Oh, same old problem. Harley Ann does the best to be nice and people get the wrong ends of the stick.
Oh, really?
Amazing, isn't it? You know, they actually accused her of killing that gerbil on purpose, just for fun.
It was an accident, was it?
Well, she's heavy-footed, I'll give you that. But it's hardly a hanging offence.
You can't just go breaking in.
I've gone off that all of a sudden, have you?
Right, you wait round the side and I'll ring the bell.
And then what?
And then I'll use my feminine words.
Just get him to open the door and I'll do the rest. Any sign of him yet?
Give us a chance. Here he comes now.
Yeah.
That's a nice welcome, isn't it?
Well, what do you want? A word with you. Get in there. You know, this is like a dream come true.
Oh, it's nothing. I'd have done the same for anyone in the same position.
Who'd have thought I'd have ended up living with a celebrity?
Hardly a celebrity.
Now, no need for false modesty around me. You're the man who put Gossinger's on the map.
Well, anyway, your roommate's up there.
My own room and all. Listen, I'll make sure I pull my weight. This place will be like a new pin when I'm finished with it.
Have you thought about what I said?
Your cheap little blackmail scheme might work with some of your dozy mates, but it doesn't with me.
Bad no, then.
Get stuffed.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you, then.
Even if you did tell Bev, it'd be your word against mine. Who do you think she's gonna believe? Some little tart straight out of prison? Or a boyfriend?
Are you sure about that?
Positive. You'll be out of that door so fast your feet won't touch the ground.
You're gonna get yours, big style. I'll make sure of that.
You put your brother up to saying Sinbad touched them.
No, I never.
Yeah, you did.
Look, this is getting us nowhere. Now listen, you little myth. Either tell Tim the truth or you're gonna be sorry.
I'm not afraid of you.
Well, you should be.
Listen, it's gonna take more than Britney Spears here to get me filling my kicks. What you gonna do? Whip me to death with the pigtails?
Why did you do it, eh? What did Sinbad ever do to you?
It's what he did to Andrew that counts.
He never did anything.
Maybe he did, maybe he didn't.
There you go. You just more or less admitted it.
So what if it did? You go and tell them, and I'll only deny it. You can't prove anything.
You're gonna tell the busies what you've done.
Make me.
Thank God.
Peace at last.
She does my head in.
Never mind.
And I don't think I can take much more of that minty caravan either.
Yeah, well, we haven't got a choice, have we?
We have. We can still move into Mix.
No way. That place doesn't exactly hold happy memories for me.
This is your last chance. You're gonna tell the busies the truth.
I'm telling them nothing.
Right then, you've asked for it.
Tim, leaving is not worth it.
Only if he agrees to go and see the busies.
No way. Your mate's going down.
Tim! Tim, stop it, you're gonna kill him! What have you done?
Is he okay?
Oh yeah, he's top. In fact, I've never seen him look better.
She's still breathing?
Yeah. We better get off before they get back.
Something smells nice.
That'd be Steve's aftershave.
No, I don't think so.
It's probably the curry. That'll be it. What are they having with him, Mum?
Couscous.
Actually, it's pronounced cuckoo. Katrina was telling me earlier.
Cuckoo?
Cuckoo, cuckoo.
It's French.
Have you been there a lot?
Not really, but I did it for a year at school, and I always watch those holiday shows on the telly.
Oh, right. Well, you never know. You might get the chance to travel a bit with your modelling.
Yeah?
Katrina's a boss model, don't you think that?
Go away, Steve. You're embarrassing me.
Hey, don't hide your light under a bushel, love.
Or your sausages.
Good point, Ed. Or your gossages. You know, I don't reckon he would have shifted any more pork if they'd had Cindy Crawford doing them ads.
Really?
Defo. Think he'll have the baking companies after you next.
I'd only done garden sheds before this campaign.
Garden sheds, eh? Well, that's what got that Kate Moss one started, wasn't it? Yeah. Garden sheds catalogue for a company in Wigan.
No, I don't think so.
You sure?
Yeah, I definitely remember reading that Kate Moss was discovered getting on some flight going to New York. Maybe it's Naomi Campbell you're thinking about.
I thought you were fine with Mix now. I mean, you seem fine at the party.
Doesn't mean I want to live there. Anyway, that Susanna Morrissey be tripping in and out every 2 minutes.
But I thought you couldn't stand her.
I can't, that's what I'm saying.
So why let her and Luke Musgrove make the decisions for you?
I am not.
Nikki, that's exactly what you're doing.
How'd you work that one out?
Well, we both agreed that the caravan's too small, right? And that the Wicked Witch of the West's driving us up the wall.
Yeah.
Well, there's a perfectly good place next door, close enough so that you can keep an eye on your Emily, and you're letting Susanna stand in our way.
I'm not. It's just
it's
a...
mad. It's like you're letting her dictate what we do, even where we live.
Maybe you're right.
Nikki, it's the perfect solution. You know it is.
OK, I give in.
So you're saying we can move in?
Yeah, I suppose.
Nice one. I'll go round and tell Mick the savvy.
This is nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is the first time our Steve's invited anybody back here.
Mum?
Don't be soft, I'm only saying.
I'll take it as a compliment.
Thought we were having lasagna.
We thought wrong then.
Hey, Di, do you remember that lasagna we had when we met Paul Daniels?
I thought you were going to behave.
You met Paul Daniels?
Yeah, well, me and Di went to see his show, you know.
It was in Blackpool, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, to cut a long story short, he got me up on stage to do a trick, but it all went wrong.
What happened?
He smashed me watch with a hammer. Only he was dead nice about it. You know, he gave us a cheque for a new watch and invited us out for dinner.
Go away.
Yeah, which is where the lasagna comes in, because he insisted on ordering a great big dish of the stuff. And when I cut into it, you'll never guess what I found.
You watch?
No, there was mince and tomato and garlic. Oh,
no. Pay no attention, love. He tells the same boring jokes every time someone new comes round.
You had me going there as well.
Do you like living on your own?
Yeah, I suppose I do.
I wouldn't fancy it myself. I enjoy the company.
I enjoy the independence.
Loneliness more like. Man's a social animal. That's what my nan always said. Here you go.
Oh, thanks.
Vodka tonic, shaken, not stirred. How is it?
Perfect.
Not too much tonic?
No, it's fine.
It's a relief. Oh, yeah. Is this all? There you go. That's better.
That is better.
No sense in ruining your posture for the sake of a cushion. What's on?
Oh, usual nonsense.
Hey, have you never thought about doing some telly? They could use you, you know.
Hardly think a few billboards and one commercial qualifies me.
Star quality is star quality. I could just see you on the box. England's answer to George Clooney.
I wouldn't mind his money.
Have you had any more thoughts on what you might like for dinner?
You decide.
Because if you don't fancy the ginger pork and Thai noodles, or if that sauteed chicken sounds too fattening, I could always nip out the shops.
Well, either or either would be fine.
Shall I surprise you?
You do that. I can get used to this.
That was lovely, Mrs. Murray.
Thanks.
Nobody does cuckoo like you do, Di.
Ignored him. He's mad.
Well, that's a nice thing to say about your old fella, isn't it? And only this morning I was saying to your mother what a lovely couple you make.
Dad, will you lay off?
Mart.
What did I say? You see that, Aunt? You can't even compliment some people these days.
Hadn't we best make a move if we're going to catch the start of that film?
What film?
You know, the film that you wanted to see.
No.
Hey, that Kate Moss isn't in it, is she, by any chance?
Is it set in the shed?
I'm sure you'll remember when we get there.
Thanks, Di. We never discussed any film.
I know, I just wanted to get out of there.
Why, I was having a lovely time.
I hope you two are happy.
What have we done?
Skit and Trina like that. You haven't even noticed. That's not the point.
We're only having a bit of fun.
Pity Steve didn't see the funny side. The first time he brings a girl home and you two start acting like a couple of school kids.
Well, I am at school.
What's your dad's excuse?
And welcome to the show.
Yeah, you shouldn't have gone to all this trouble. I usually order a pizza.
I've got to pay my way somehow. I don't want you to think I'm spongy.
Oh,
I'll get it.
I'm really sorry to bother you, but it's all Lance here.
Yes, of course. Come in.
What's wrong, babe?
I just finished my shift and I don't have anywhere to go.
Well, wasn't Dave going to lend you some dosh?
Yeah, but the tight girl wouldn't cover.
You mean you're homeless too?
One of my mates was meant to be lending me a few quid and he backed out at the last minute and I don't have anywhere to go.
You know, I'm sorry, but I already have one house guest.
Couldn't you stay?
I don't want people thinking I'm running some kind of a hostel.
Well, she could have my bed.
Well, where would you stay?
Well, we could share a room. Max, Ollie Ann wouldn't survive a night on the streets. She's not as strong as she looks.
Well, then...
I shouldn't have come. Don't worry about me, I'll be okay. It's not like it's the depths of winter or anything.
Okay, you can stay.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, don't go, friend. I'll be out your head in no time.
Andrew, go and get me the phone.
Kevin, what happened? Who did this to you?
Nobody.
Ambulance, please.
I'm fine.
Don't move. Wait till they get here.
So what do you reckon to Trona, then?
Well, she's a plank.
I'll have to admit she's not the sharpest tool in the box.
Do you think Cade and Steve will ever get married?
Nah. It's his first girlfriend. She's just for practice.
It's a good job I don't have to worry about all that then.
How do you mean?
Oh, I'm going to be a priest, aren't I? They don't have girlfriends.
Oh, yeah. Of course.
You've got customers, you know.
I was just keeping an eye out.
For what?
Well, Bev, you'll think I'm mad.
Try me.
Well, I think people are using the box in here to do drugs.
Flaming hell. That's all I need, a bunch of junkies using the place.
Well, I'm not saying it's defo going on, but you might want to check it out, you know.
Don't worry, I will.
What do you think he's saying?
Doesn't take a genius to work that one out, does it? He's dobbing us in. Why couldn't you just left it, eh?
I don't know what came over me. I just lost it.
We're finished.
Don't say that.
Why not? It's true. As soon as he speaks to the busies, that's it.
Hello? Anyone in here? I can hear you, and I don't want any druggies in my bar.
Could you do this to me?
It's Greg Shadwick's anniversary today.
Get away. That came round quick, didn't it?
I decided to stay on what's going to do me levels.
Oh, good girl, then.
I've done you a favour!
What, by putting Kevin in the hospital? Yeah, that'll be the busies now.
That's all to come on Friday at 8 o'clock. Looking for the ideal flatmate who's no stranger to a pair of rubber gloves next on 4. Emma Kennedy's in Manchester with this week's hopefuls.
They might turn up at any time, mightn't they?
Oh, why not go the whole hog, eh?
What?
Get yourself down the cop shop, save them the petrol, tell them everything.
I just want to tell Sinbad the truth. I owe him the truth.
You are mad.
Oh. It's today, isn't it?
I've just spoke to my mum on the phone.
How did she sound?
Chaotic. This time last year, they were still alive. If I'd have known they were going to die, I'd have just been nicer.
Hey, you're only a kid. You still are.
I just miss them.
I was hoping you'd be ready to talk.
You've got Bob Hope and no hope.
All right, I've let you down.
Probably should have worn me rubber gloves with that. There's syringes in there and all kinds.
I don't shoot up. I never have.
No, you just balls up other people's lives.
Bev!
So finish your packing and sling it up.
Don't I get to say anything?
What is there to say? You were bent over a bog snorting coke.
I'm sorry. I had my reasons.
I really thought we had something special.
We still do.
Anything you leave behind is going to the Oxfam.
At least hear me out.
Leave your keys on the side, and if you're still here when I get back, I'm calling the police.
What are you doing?
I always knew it was too good to be true.
I can't believe it's a year.
Who was that ringing at 8 o'clock?
Margie.
Couldn't you have left it till later?
She was upset. She wanted to know how we were.
Sleeping like a bear until she phoned.
Me dad and me brother died a year ago.
Aye, aye. There goes trouble.
It's Greg Shadwick's anniversary today.
Get away. I came round quick, didn't I?
In some ways.
Are you okay?
Me? I was lucky. I'm alive.
You on your own?
No. Jimmy and Jackie are hiding in the knife throw. What's up? MI5 tailing it again, are they?
How long do you reckon it'd take for the busies to follow up a complaint?
Why, what have you done?
Something I should have done a long time ago.
Now, this hasn't got anything to do with me, has it? You've been round to Barbara's again?
Yeah.
Tim!
Oh, hang on a minute. Look, things are looking good for you. Better by the minute, in fact.
Why, what have you done?
I went round to see that Kevin. I ended up giving him a bit of a going over.
Oh, no.
Keep your wig on. The wimps ended up an Aussie. But he hasn't called the busies.
You're putting that stuff on to go to the cemetery?
I'm just making an effort to look nice, OK?
As for you, young lady, your face and your neck are different colours. Oh. Hey, are there any flowers left in this city?
That abicina, I'll get it.
These are from Margie. Aren't they pretty?
Aye, a pretty penny.
Oh. Oh.
God in heaven, what's she got there?
They're beautiful, love.
It's vulgar. All that money wasted on showing grief.
Why don't we just get a couple of dandelions and put them in a jam jar, eh?
Aye, if it's all you can afford. Have you never heard of the widow's mite? Right then, now we're going to have another brew before we go.
Over to you, darling.
I owe you one.
Well, like I said, it's only temporary. I'll have to check with Sinbad.
But me and Nicky can still have a look around later, though.
Yeah, I run it by Sin the Savvy. It's the last place he wants to be, so...
Nice one. Is that chilli?
Why don't you come over tonight? Even if it's just for half an hour, I've all the chilli you want.
As if I'm going to let my favourite landlord down.
She's so grouchy when she's tired.
Ah, you'll never get enough tonight.
Not my problem. It's Mike's turn.
There's you looking like butter wouldn't melt.
How's Anthea?
Oh, she's fine. She's going to pick me suit up later from the dry cleaners. I got pelted by an egg down at the court, didn't I? Wasn't meant for me, like.
Do you throw an egg at Simba?
He was just a tomato short of the full English.
Oh, better go and see him.
She did try sponging it like, but...
Right, Mummy's coming now.
£9 it's going to cost me. £9, can you believe that, for one egg? But, man, it's only 73p for half a dozen.
I thought everything had calmed down.
Not from where I'm standing, babe. I'm sorry, but I'm afraid your mate is going down.
We won't be long, Mum.
She's got you wrapped round her little finger.
Oh, it's going to be a tough day for Jessie today.
She's loving every minute of it. I'm glad I got here in time. A few months later, she'd have had you walking up the aisle.
I told you to stay out of it!
I've done you a favour!
What, by putting Kevin in the hospital? Yeah, that'll be the busies now.
He practically sprints her back into the ambulance.
You swore blind that you'd leave her. You told me, you promised me.
What's going on?
Somebody had to do something.
You know nothing! No wonder the army knocked you back.
What?
Sinbad, calm down.
You're not deaf. You're thick. There's nothing going on between them ears. There's a gale blowing right through.
Why hasn't he called the busies then, eh?
Oh, he will. And it'll be me that gets arrested.
I thought everything was okay.
You're joking, aren't you? He's just put the final nail in me coffin.
Hi, Victoria.
Hey.
You and Daryl still off for tonight?
Yeah, of course. Looking forward to it.
Nice one.
But Jackie phoned before. She's looking a bit iffy.
Oh, no.
6 bottles of champers.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Thanks, Beth.
There you go. I've done your 10% discount.
Oh, cheers. Beth.
I'm busy.
Why didn't you just snaffle a few bottles from the restaurant?
Didn't want Susanna twigging. It's a surprise, remember?
Oh, she's a lucky girl.
Will you just hear me out, please?
You're wasting your breath and my time.
I am not a dealer.
I'd rather have a thief than a liar.
When I told you my dealing days were over, I meant it.
Dealing? Using? You're still crawling around the gutter.
But I'm not, though, am I? I've been really good these past few months, thanks to you.
Right, yeah.
I mean it. We're good together.
Don't patronise me. I know that people look at us and what they think. They think, what's he doing with her? I've thought it myself. I mean, how someone like him's ended up with someone like me.
Don't put yourself down.
When I saw you coked off your head in that bog, I knew why. Because you're a loser. And I'm a magnet for losers.
Something happened to me. Something bad. I mean, really bad. Can't we just talk after work? If you want me to go, I'll leave. Just hear me out, please.
Maybe I should put some of these in the church.
I want that in the grave.
Yours can have pride of place then.
This is where my dad said this, isn't it? That means that his hand's supposed to be here. When I was little, I used to think his hands were massive. I used to try and get all the slummy out of his pockets. He used to crunch me knuckles.
Hey, do you remember we used to make him play hair salons? Dad would be sitting there trying to watch the footy. Me and Ed would be sticking all our hair grips in his head.
What about Jason's head lice?
When was this?
He was 14 and mortified.
He had the biggest cob on. I reckon he caught them off that poor leather.
I threatened to tell you the first time you came to ours. You made him pay me £3, I keep stunned. I wasn't really going to tell you. But it took us money anyway.
Tell her what you've done, will you?
If you let me get a word in, yeah?
Look, me and Emily went round to see that Kevin.
I've gathered that much.
Well, it gets better and better this, Rach.
I thought I'd go round and try and persuade him to tell the truth.
Yeah, by beating him up.
You haven't.
Will you let me finish?
What did he say?
Not a lot. I ended up landing him one.
The poor kid's in hospital.
Yeah. And how come he hasn't blown the whistle?
And this was last night?
He's obviously bricking it.
Oh, I'd have thought that Barbara would have well been onto the place by now.
Oh, I've given up trying to second-guess Barbara.
Don't you think it's weird the way Kevin hasn't grassed me up yet?
Yeah, I do.
Don't encourage him, Rachel. He's a thug.
No, cheers.
Stop it, you two. Yeah, what Tim did was wrong.
Wrong? It was madness.
Yeah, but he's got a point. The police still aren't showed up.
I rest my case.
Pity you didn't rest your fists.
Where are you going?
To get air. You two can play detective until the cows come home, but the bottom line is, he's put a 15-year-old kid in the Aussie in my name. They're gonna throw away the key.
Well, she's gonna suss it, isn't she? She's gonna see all the scrum.
No, I'll hide it all at number five.
So, what's the sister like?
Too old for you.
Is she a blondie like your Susie?
Well, she won't be coming. I rang her yesterday. She says Susanna lurches from one disaster to the next.
Cheeky cow. You're not a disaster.
Hmm, thanks, sir.
You just marrying one?
Yeah.
Man, I've got some news for you.
Oh?
Don't worry, I'm not up to duff or nothing. I've decided to stay on at school and do my levels.
Oh, good girl, Em. Do you hear that, Greg?
Nice one, Swat. Might lend you my protractor.
Do you think he did hear that?
I'm sure he did. You've got two guardian angels there who can see everything you do.
Everything.
I don't know how often you pray, but always remember your dad when you do.
Because he needs him more than Jason.
Jason was still a child. Your dad had lived longer. He had more time to make mistakes. Without doubt, his greatest achievement was you two, my best girls.
Hey, Nan, do you know if me and Nicky were drowning? Which one would you save?
What a question.
OK, if me and Tim were drowning, who would you save?
Behave, you. But don't tell Tim, then he'll go away.
Right, we're all having our lunch in Bev's bar. On me.
Ah, oh, thanks, Nan. We can go measure up the curtains after, can't we?
Or we could go now whilst they have the dinner.
Get lost, I'm starving.
Let's not mention we've had lunch to Mum, yeah?
Why? Doesn't she approve of you having square meals? OK.
Look, I'm glad I've seen you. Look, I know I'm going to hide into nothing here, but me and Susanna are having an engagement party tonight.
Congratulations.
Oh, God's sake, how long's this going to go on for?
Try forever.
Look, I've been made up to have you there tonight. You of all people.
I'd love to.
Who'll come?
Best not. I mean, what if little Harry's there? Might not be able to resist him, might I?
Pineapple juice and a bottle of house white.
Yes, please.
Jean, I'm sure it's normal. But before I went to the grave, I was feeling dead guilty for moving on.
You're bound to.
But now, I'm not even sure if I have. I want to sleep with Steve, but part of me is terrified.
Let him wait.
But he's going to get bored or think I'm teasing him.
Give him a bit more credit than that.
I know. But now I've kind of made it bigger than it is. This massive thing hanging over us.
I think you're overthinking it.
Come on.
What?
You can't just dangle a big juicy carrot like that in front of me and then change the subject.
I told you, it was nothing.
But who was nothing?
It doesn't matter. It was just sex.
Who was she?
Nobody. It meant nothing.
God, you're turning into me.
Don't do that to yourself.
The old me. So this non-person, was it nothing to her as well?
We both agreed it was a mistake.
What about Susanna?
What about her?
Party tonight.
Oh, yeah, of course.
I said to Mick that we'd be there to hide behind the door and all that stuff.
Fine, same again.
Hey, I can't stop. Bethany's changing. Have you heard anything?
Nope.
Tim, I know you're only trying to help.
Oh, yeah, and Sinbad was made up, wasn't he?
Oh, put yourself in his shoes.
What's the point? He hates me.
Of course he doesn't. He's just angry.
You saw him. He lost it. It's all that sicko's fault. I'm glad they gave him a kicking.
Any sign of the busies?
No.
Well, do you reckon he's guilty or what?
What do you make of that, Kevin?
I feel sorry for him.
What?
Well, he's sick, isn't he? He's got to be. Why else would he make Andrew lie like that?
I was going to ask you before, but you're too busy biting my head off.
Do what you want.
Hey, look, they know it's your room. When you want to move back in, they'll ship out. You're starting to do me head in, you know.
Thanks for at least hearing me out.
I'm picking Josh up in an hour.
Remember a couple of weeks ago when I went AWOL and you thought that I'd got off? Well, that was the beginning of the end, I suppose.
Go on.
I used to keep some very shady company. The bloke who had me stabbed decided he wanted to twist the knife and had me brought to him.
The bloke who stabbed you?
I think he'd been watching too many episodes of The Sweeney. I was knocked out, dragged in a car, and delivered to him.
Oh, my God.
Only this time he wasn't wielding a knife. He was toting a gun.
Celebrate our engagement.
So this big ringleader's dead then?
Yeah, his sidekick turned nasty on him and I managed to get away.
Well, could he come after you?
No, I'm small fry.
How did you get sucked into this world, eh? Knives and guns.
I don't know. I was naive, arrogant, I suppose. I thought I could handle it. One minute I'm selling a few E's, the next I'm looking down the barrel of a gun.
Could have been you swimming with the fishes.
It nearly was. Thought a line of coke would help me escape the bad things.
For about 30 seconds, maybe.
You were the best thing in my life. And the irony was, I was only doing coke to keep it together. To keep us together. And now I've lost you.
Hey. I'll be the judge of that. When I found you nose deep in that stuff, I could have killed you. I felt so betrayed.
I know.
I trusted you with my son.
I'd never hurt Josh.
You don't know what you'd do when you're off your head on coke.
Listen, do you want to come off drugs?
Of course.
Because next to Josh, you mean everything to me.
You'll give us another go?
I want to help you, not judge you. Just don't let me down.
Welcome. It's a party, you're meant to mingle.
You mingle away then.
Have I done the wrong thing?
Oh.
I have, Aveline. I knew you didn't look right before.
It's lovely, thoughtful.
But?
It's Greg Shadwick's anniversary.
What, today? I'm sorry, I didn't think.
It was the first thing I thought of this morning.
The last thing you need is a party.
Hey, Dad, the chili's the finest.
I'll see if anyone needs a top-up.
Sorry.
Oh.
So why didn't you invite your Cheryl, eh?
Why didn't you invite your Nikki?
Yeah, right.
She gave you the pass out then?
Not exactly, no.
Can't be more than you already are.
The bell's on that.
Raymond, move!
Oh, sorry, Mum. And why did they turn it up? I can't hear it. What with the blethering in here and that music from next door?
Leave us as it is, please, Ray. We'll blether all we like.
Come on
out. Where did Jerome go?
Oh, he's probably playing pool. He is loud, that.
Oh, I've not seen that one before. Can I borrow it? I'll make a copy.
Of course you can, love. You can borrow as many as you like.
I'll make sure I look after it.
You made the right pigs here.
Sounds like a party, isn't it? I mean, today of all days.
I was watching that. There's a perfectly good portable in your bedroom. And where do you think you're going, madam?
See her next door, the cheeky cow.
People's lives don't revolve around the weeping and wailing of Shadwick women, you know.
Mom?
No. Kissy's right, Ray. There's been enough doom and gloom in this house to last a lifetime. So here's a bit of good news. Ray and I are getting married.
You and Darren seem back on track as friends.
Yeah, but, Darren's had a derailment.
Oh?
Well, he's being all cagey about it, but he's had a meaningless bonk.
Meaningless? Really?
Well, so he says. I don't think she's at a bunny boiler or anything like that. I just hope that she regrets it as much as he does. Let's hope so.
Sorry to be a party pooper, everyone, but I'm trying to have a conversation with my dead brother's fiancé, and all I can hear is your music.
All right, Nikki. I'm sorry.
Tell you what, in 10 minutes, it's going to be exactly a year since they died. I don't know if you want to stick a few candles on a cake, have a sing-song, pin the tail on a donkey, maybe?
Yeah, easy, Nikki, you've made your point.
Oh, a nice one, you, from the grave to the rave.
Yeah, well, Mick is me dad's cousin, and I've spent the whole day with your family.
Oh, sorry, I didn't realise you were keeping a log.
And Nikki, Mick is our new landlord.
Oh, whatever. Oh, well, nice timing, Susanna. What do you do on your kid's anniversary? Put all bunting round the close.
Hey, Nikki, I organise this party. And I asked our Jerome to come round, so if you're blaming anybody, you blame me, okay? Sorry for landing you in the doghouse.
Beats that caravan any day. And if anybody should be apologising, it should be Nikki.
Well, aren't you going to go after her?
No chance.
Nice.
It's like, the more that I give her, the more she expects it. Will you go and get another drink, please?
Right, well, thanks for the best banoffee pie in the world.
You're welcome.
Oh, don't go.
No, I'd better have. I've got work tomorrow, so... Congratulations.
Oh.
Congrats.
Yeah, I'll see you outside. I'm going to make a move as well.
Oh, there's a surprise. Thanks for coming. And do be careful on your way home. You don't have any more disastrous encounters.
Taylor. Kevin Taylor. Okay. Well, thanks anyway. Yeah, that's a good idea. Okay, thanks, bye.
Good night, gorgeous.
Hey, Timmy Mally. I won't keep your hands off the money, bit.
Give my love to Kitty galore. Hey, you'll always have me, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Taylor. Yeah, that's right. Yesterday tea time. I'm his cousin. Thanks. She's checking. He is. Right, okay. Right, thanks very much. Bye. Bingo. He's in the infirmary.
Should have kept him in overnight.
And tonight and all, by the sounds of it.
God, he must be pretty bad.
Maybe it's a blessing in disguise.
Oh, why, yeah?
Well, in a hospital bed, he's a captive audience. Maybe I can get through to him.
How do you mean?
It's like you said, Andrew's story is too rehearsed. Maybe Kevin is behind it. And if he is, it's not the kind of story you pluck from midair or pick up in the playground during break.
Right.
I think me and Kevin have got something in common.
Never happier.
No, I'm a friend of a friend.
But I haven't got any friends.
Love, you've only known the woman 2 minutes.
A friend like that is like gold dust.
And do you know if we ever catch you doing this? We're saying it's a level playing field. I'll finish with you.
Oh, Hadaway, man. You were as shocked as I was when she dropped that bombshell.
So we didn't send them around then.
A week's worth of Brookie in one evening. That's The Omnibus at 25 to 8 tomorrow. Next, it's decision time and Davina as we wait to meet the Big Brother evictee.